Hello, my name is Dr. Triandos and I am consultant in the gastroenterology department in the University Hospital of Patras in Greece. I was asked by the editors of Clinical Gastroenterology and Hepatology to discuss a paper coming out in the journal entitled Critical Illness-Related Corticosteroid Insufficiency in Patients with Cirrhosis and Variceal Bleeding. Patients with liver cirrhosis have hemodynamic abnormalities that also occur in patients with septic shock or adrenal insufficiency. Liver failure could contribute to adrenal insufficiency by increasing levels of endotoxin and impairing cholesterol synthesis. In addition, bacterial infections that occur frequently in patients with cirrhosis might be related to altered synthesis of adrenal cortisol. Patients with variceal bleeding are critically ill patients and are often managed in intensive care and have frequent infections. An international task force uses the term critical illness-related corticosteroid insufficiency and defines it as inadequate cellular corticosteroid activity for the severity of the patient's illness. We evaluated critical illness-related corticosteroid insufficiency in a prospective study of patients with variceal bleeding, patients with stable cirrhosis, and healthy volunteers. 20 cirrhotic patients with variceal bleeding were evaluated using the short SYNACTEN test and 10 using the low-dose SYNACTEN test, followed by the short SYNACTEN test. The control group included 60 stable cirrhotic patients, 50 assessed by low-dose SYNACTEN test and 10 by short SYNACTEN test and 14 healthy volunteers. Adrenal insufficiency was diagnosed using the short SYNACTEN test based on peak cortisol levels below or equal 18 microgram per dL in non-stressed patients and delta max below 9 microgram per dL or a total cortisol level below 10 microgram per dL in stressed patients with variceal bleeding, the current criteria for critical illness-related corticosteroid insufficiency. Using the low-dose SYNACTEN test, diagnosis was based on peak concentration of cortisol below or equal 18 microgram per dL in non-stressed patients and below 25 microgram per dL or delta max below 9 microgram per dL in patients with variceal bleeding. We also evaluated patients with levels of serum albumin above 2.5 grams per dL to indirectly assess cortisol binding. Dear colleagues, a large percentage of patients with variceal bleeding have abnormal results from the short SYNACTEN test based on the criteria of critical illness-related corticosteroid insufficiency. Among patients with adrenal insufficiency, those with variceal bleeding had a higher baseline and peak levels of cortisol than stable patients with cirrhosis, but similar delta max values. This indicates that during variceal bleeding, there is a hyperactivation of HPA axis. This is the first report of these findings in patients with variceal bleeding. In conclusion, adrenal dysfunction is common among patients with variceal bleeding and cirrhosis compared to stable patients with cirrhosis and a similar degree of liver dysfunction. The higher basal levels of cortisol in patients with variceal bleeding compared to stable patients with cirrhosis indicates that variceal bleeding induces critical illness-related corticosteroid insufficiency. Finally, I want to thank all the contributors in this study. Thank you for your attention.